So this forward assist can be removed, and most of the Rattlers that are sold don't have that. That I've seen, at least, and I could be wrong, but it's just kind of like a polymer piece right here as your deflector, but there's no forward assist. And that's a whole other argument, and it's just the benefits. But I have used in 10 years, I have used a forward assist almost in every moment I've shot in for.
Yeah.
It's just, for me, it's just one of those things. It's trained into it. What are you losing?
I agree, Dan. And, you know, kind of going down from there for controls. Controls are very M4-like. In fact, I'm a little bit improved. The magazine release is a little bit longer, so it's very easy to hit. That kind of brings me to a big point, which is magazines. Subsonic rounds do not run well through Black Ops specific magazines because they need a little bit more. These are Lancers, pretty well as well. You can't overload the Lancers, so be careful with that. But they are well done. That kind of brings us over to the other side, which is our, we have a magazine release on that side as well, and our bolt release right there. So, very M4-like, very well done. I don't really have any complaints when it comes to any of the controls on this weapon.
Yeah, if you took this lower, and really, aside from not having a buffer too, it's an arrow.
Yeah,
it's something that you know, and that is easily trained.
And again, our safety's right here, and that's just right. So we have it on that side, and then a shortened one on the opposite side, which is perfect. So if I'm firing, you know, long range or something like that, that'll engage that safety from that same side, or if you're heavy, or if you're shooting lefty.
Yeah,
perfect right there. Now, on this particular gun, we do have a Geising trigger on it, because I've previously already done a ghosting trigger of the regular FTX trigger, which is quite good. So, for the first time in Grand Theft history, me and Sean are going to ghost that trigger together. So, he's going to put his finger right over mine. It's ticking.
Oh,
God,
that's intense. Are you pulling or are you pulling?
You can pull. Okay, so we get into it. So, we have a little about 3 millimeters to play. Okay, we're.
Okay,
it's nice.
Wow.
Okay, still about one more time.
Was it good for you?
It was really good.
That was good for me.
A little one more time. I got like powder hands, dude. It's like. Okay, go ahead and do it again. Okay, go on. Yeah, about 3 millimeters of play. Yeah, that's nice. Guys, these triggers are, of course, incredible. I have a lot to say about them, so they do make them for NCX events, so that's pretty cool.
Good grips. Very
simple, man.
But again, modularity. That's going to be a ticket item for this rifle right here. Modularity.
For sure, man. And that brings us to the FPV points on. Both it built into the lower and into the handguard right there, so it makes your life easier. And then finally, to what Sean was talking about last, we have the saw. And 1913 is an awesome attachment method for a saw.
It is. And again, so SIG offers, you know, they have this version, they have a scalp knife version, they have the wire, so, you know,
yeah,
the actually position here. So
the M4 stock,
they have the two position wire stock. Again, it's all about what we're talking about, the actual length of this rifle. Without a suppressor, when you start folding the stock up, it's 16 inches.
Yeah.
Folded into a bag under the CDR, whatever it was designed for you, you just change it from there. That's all. And then actually, for being not a standard M4 butt stock, and being so thin, I actually really
like it. It reminds me of the DCM stock, which I've always been kind of a
fan
of.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of that stock.
So they definitely did a great job. I mean, this is a cool gun. It definitely has an application. I don't figure out if it's good. Also, if you like the SIG MCX quite a bit, I kind of was a little bit disappointed in the first MCX that we ever got.
M6.
But,
I'm sorry.
You have to.
I can't.
On the NCO. But, you know, these newer versions are pretty awesome. You know, we've talked enough. So what we're going to do now is kind of show you how quiet this thing is. We're going to put the camera down range. We're going to fire from 20, 40, 50, 60, 100.
Okay.
And then we'll get up there at the camera so the camera can hear how long it takes for a subsonic rat to hang out, because there is not a lot of power.
No, it's like it feels like shooting a 45.
It does, and it does have
it does.
What's the power of a 300 watt, like a subsonic 300 blackout?
From what I've seen, it's like about the same shooting a 9mm out of a 5-inch barrel.
Okay.
So you're hitting, the velocities are different, but when you talk about impact at 100, you're dealing with about the same force. So it's going to do the job.
It's because
it's going to get there.
It'll get there.
It'll get
there. For sure. So you understand that with a subsonic. A subsonic is a subsonic.